Alright, welcome to part two. So if you remember last time, this one represented the living water, Christ Jesus, amen? And this represents our cups, okay? So I'm going to do a part two to this, and this is going to help us a lot more too. So check this out, family. So the first video, we were talking about how to get closer to the Lord, amen? And we're realizing, depending on what size scoop that we have, is going to be how much we can get filled, amen? So we got all these different sizes, amen? So part two to this is going to be how the enemy works against us. Amen. So here we are with our full cups. And this is what happens. Oh, the Lord is so good. So remember, you have to go watch my other video if you have not to even understand what's happening here. Otherwise, you will miss it completely. Okay. So if you have this, remember, this is representing the best type of scoop we can have. We go to the living water and we get a ton of water, right? And we get to pour it into our cups. Amen. But if you have, you got to bear with me. If you have this scoop, the enemy at one time can only do the opposite. Let me explain. If you have the biggest cup, the enemy can ever only do the opposite of what you have. So I have the smallest scoop. So the enemy can only hurt you, right? One, by like if we skip a day in reading our word or, maybe not pray for a couple days. The only thing the enemy can be able to do to you is have this. So he can only do this. So because you were so indwelt in the Holy Spirit, because you were so diligent in seeking the Lord, the enemy can only ever do this much from you. So while you skip a couple days, the enemy goes like this. But he's going to take it. You better believe he's going to be so happy he can at least get this, right? And he's going to be scooping it, right? He's going to be scooping it. And right now, it's not a big deal. It's going to take the enemy a very, very long time. In fact, we may even die before he can get us to empty our cups, amen? So we're here, and it's awesome that we stay in the Word. But remember, if we have this and the enemy's scooping with this, whenever we go back, we just get another huge scoop and then the enemy got to start all over again. Amen. But watch this. If all of a sudden the enemy gets too many scoops, he's going to graduate and you're going to demote. So you're going to go from this to this. You can only get this much. And then the enemy is going to be able to take the opposite this much. All right. So you can get a pretty good scoop still, right? A nice solid scoop. You can get full real easy. But now the enemy has the ability to take a bit more. And you know he's going to be happy to take it. It's gone. Boom. Gone. Right? And again, not so much of a problem right now that you can now go and just get a big scoop and coming back, okay? But the enemy's gonna slowly, slowly increase his sizes that he's gonna get you to stumble in sin, okay? So, now we're gonna go this way. We got this nice big scoop, but then also we got the one coming right next to it. So this is, again, a pretty good size. I'm trying to get you to see it. How is this camera even working? Okay. So as you can see, this one is still pretty big. This one is close, but not as big. So it's pretty even. So check this out. You're going to be trying to take big scoops from the living water. And the enemy is going to be taking from your cup, right? And you're going to go here. And the enemy is going to go here. Right now, it's an even battle. Remember I said, you can get caught up on the whys here. And once you're caught up on the whys here, it's a battle, and you can never, ever progress as much as you want because the enemy takes just as much away as you put in. This is a good illustration. I hope we're understanding this, amen? So, we're tied here, amen? Again, we can flip-flop these. Now the enemy's taking a little bit more, but it's still a pretty even fight. We got the enemy taking a kind of big scoop, then you're fighting back right away. Boom, right? And again, he's still taking a little more. So eventually he's going to upgrade if you don't get it in gear. Amen. And we get it in gear by praying, fasting, seeking the Lord, going to our prayer closet. Amen. Sharing the word of Christ. Amen. Again, this has nothing to do with salvation. This has everything to do with your relationship with the Lord. I'll get into salvation later. And I do not believe in once saved, always saved. So that's not where I'm going with this. Okay. I believe if you act righteous, not within your own self, but if your faith is truly in Christ Jesus, you will be born again. You will repent. You will do all those things necessary in Christ Jesus, that then your salvation is solidified by your faith. Amen. You can't say, I believe in Jesus and worship the devil at the same time. It does not work that way, no matter how many times you pray. If you are literally on the altar of Satan and at the feet of Satan and at the feet of the world all day, every day, and you just happen to know the name of Jesus, he's not going to say, well done, my good and faithful servant. It will be hellfire. Amen. That's just common sense. That's knowledge. Amen. So back to the illustration. We're kind of fighting back and forth. Yes, going back and forth. Still a tie. But now, once the enemy upgrades one more after this, the enemy is here and we're stuck here. So at one time we could have been here, but because we went back into the world, because we lost faith, because maybe we had some type of roadblock and we waited too long and the enemy just kept taking and taking. Now the enemy's graduated to this, and now he scoops this much out of you. And you got beat down, you got wore down. He pours it away. Amen. And you fighting, and you can only scoop out this much. This much. And let's say you're both really fast at scooping. The enemy has so much ground over you that you would have to work 10 times as hard of scooping than the enemy would. Amen. I hope we're understanding this. And last but not least, if the enemy is scooping with this in your walk and you're only scooping with this, you have to reevaluate. Okay? And sometimes we can be in this season for a moment, for a day. We can have a bad day, a really bad day, and say, dang, I fell 32 times, totally forgot I was a Christian today. I need to ask for forgiveness. And hear me out. If you're having this day every day, you're not a Christian. Amen. We all fall short of the glory of God. But if we are in consistent living for the world, for the enemy, with no regards for Christ Jesus, no matter how many times you go to church, no matter how many times, whatever, your heart is not in this. It is a battle until the end. Amen. So if you are here, the enemy and you, reevaluate. Okay, again, we have good days and bad days. That comes with the human nature. But a majority of our days should be in Christ Jesus. Amen. So I hope this illustration has helped you understand how it's actually working in the spiritual realm. Because if you notice, some people have this level of joy in Christ Jesus that you go, why in the world does it seem like they don't go through any battles? And that's because they already went through, I only scooped with this much at first, and then I started scooping with this much, and then I moved up, right? And I kept on moving, and then all of a sudden, they scooping with this every time. So they go to the Bible and they get a huge scoop of water, and somebody's only scooping with this. The person who's scooping with this is looking at this going, how do I get from here to there? And it's so confusing. I don't get it. But not realizing this person has cried, this person has read through the Bible, this person has studied, this person has been in their prayer closet, this person has beat their flesh into submission, this person has repented, this person has done everything that they possibly could to increase their relationship with the Lord, while this person only goes to church on Sunday, and that is it. And the rest of the week, they're living for Satan. And they can never figure out why they can't get their breakthrough, they can never figure out why I can't have the joy of the Lord. They can't figure out why. It's because you don't seek the Lord with your whole heart, mind, body, soul, and spirit. It's because you don't forsake the world, right? It's because you have a lack of knowledge. Are we getting this? Don't be a small scoop. And if you are a small scoop, that is okay. Just remember, keep upgrading your scoop so you can constantly fill your cup, because you cannot survive in the end times without a full cup. Amen. And Jesus will do this awesome thing because he's infinite. Well, he'll just do this He'll take his own living water and go psh, and overflow you, okay? That is where you want to be, when he's just taking his own cup and just pouring right in. Just pouring right in. Just pouring in. Just pouring in. Again, this is infinite, but I'm not a miracle worker here. We just pour in, and he's just pouring in. And you say, Lord, give me more. Lord, give me more. Lord, give me more. More, more. And he's just pouring, and he's just pouring. That's where we want to be. And while Jesus is pouring, the enemy has to flee. The enemy has to go way back there. Okay? So, I made a huge mess on this table filled with water, and I have to clean it up now. But I hope you guys have understood this. I hope this has helped you in some type of way. I didn't come up with this illustration on my own. I literally was in my prayer closet 5 minutes ago, and the door's even cracked open. Look at that. But I was in the prayer closet just seeking the Lord, and all of a sudden he just started pouring this in my head, like, hey, do this, make sure you get this type, make sure you get this, and I want you to do an illustration of how it's working in the spirit so they can have a better understanding of how it means to seek me and what battles they may be facing that are hindering their growth and learning how to get more of me. So this is what he gave to me. So it's going to make sense to some of you out there. I hope so. I love you all so very much. If you need anything, comment. I will get back to you who have commented towards the channel already. I'm so sorry. I've been busy. I have to limit myself on YouTube only because just my own relationship with the Lord. I used to play, quick testimony, I used to do a lot of video games like Call of Duty, like 8 hours a day when I was a little bit younger and before I found Christ. So I one of my areas of weakness is technology, because I really think how cool it is. Like, I went to school for multimedia arts and technology. So like, I'm really interested in technology, and sometimes I can get so into it that I stray away from the Lord and my relationship and my time with him. So I have to learn how to limit myself. And unfortunately, if I look through too many comments, I'll just keep going and just keep going and just keep going. And I know that self, and I know that about myself. So I have to do it in sections. So I appreciate your patience. That's just one thing that I struggle with, that hopefully you can have an understanding, right? It's not like a social media addiction. I don't know how to explain it. I'm like a nerd in technology. So if new like VR glasses come out and new PCs, all that type of thing, if all that stuff comes out, I'm all about it. I'm like, oh, let's do it. And I had to learn how to take a step back from all that and seek the Lord first before I go into that realm. So that's why that is. I love you guys. Pray for me. I will pray for you. The Lord is our strength. We're not meant to do this alone. So, yes, God bless you. I love you all, and be blessed.